when you are stuck and you can't get out. When you're stuck and can't get out. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. You know, I do a lot of videos on being stuck and how to get out of being stuck. And yet those videos are for people who are just maybe too lazy to get unstuck, or for people who are just don't know how to get unstuck, or don't have the confidence to get unstuck, but they have the ability to get unstuck. And yet this video is a little bit different. This is geared for people who are stuck in a place that they did not want to be in, that they did everything possible to not be in or to get out of, and they did not usually create the situation from the start. It could be a health crisis. It could be a financial crisis. It could be a relationship crisis. It could be almost any kind of crisis where they have done the very, very, very best at getting out of it and creating their best life, and yet they remain stuck. So what do those people do? Well, you know, I believe that there are two kinds of stuck people. This kind of stuck people that can get themselves out of being unstuck, and then the kind of people that are stuck in a place that, well, they've done everything to get unstuck, and yet they can't get unstuck. So for those people who seem to not be able to get unstuck, I believe that often it has been no fault of your own that you're there. You know, sometimes a health crisis can happen. I remember 10 years ago when I had what they termed a brain aneurysm, and it was very, very challenging and difficult for me during that year. Now, I'm one of the lucky ones. I know that. I'm one of the fortunate ones. If you haven't watched my video, go back to the Diana Brienne Fairchild channel and look up brain aneurysm. And you can look up that video in detail. I'm fine today, of course. And yet, I remember that year of feeling so wobbly and so shaky and so scared and so frightened. It was a year that I had to travel through. It was a year of being stuck in a place that I did not want to be, in a health crisis that I did not bring on myself, and yet I was doing everything I could to get out of it, and yet I was in the middle of it. And so there are times that we are stuck in a place that we don't want to be. And when that happens, I believe in surrounding ourselves, of course, with the best minds that can help us get out of it. And yet, if the best minds at that time are working the best they can, and yet can't help us get out of it at the moment, if we are stuck in it at this time, whether it's a short time, a medium time, or a long-term time, we have to make the best of the situation. If it's a relationship crisis where two people are getting a divorce or breaking up, or something's happened in that relationship and they're in the middle of it, they may be stuck in the middle of that right now. And other than doing the very, very best that they can, it may be a time limited situation where they're going to be stuck. Or a financial crisis where someone did everything right and yet things fell apart. And so now they're in this midst of this being stuck in this financial crisis. It could be in any kind of situation that one finds themselves stuck. So what do you do? Well, I believe in surrounding myself with comfort people, not necessarily people that can give me good wisdom or good advice. They're just comforting people. They're people that know the right thing to say and they listen. And as I always say, grandma's bowl of soup. Sometimes grandma's bowl of soup can work wonders in comforting us during difficult and challenging times. I believe in doing things that comfort us. I believe in taking care of who we are during times of being stuck. You know, I go to several channels. I call them grandma channels. I call them prayer channels. And they're for people many times who are stuck. But those channels are so necessary. most of those people there, I don't believe, want to be stuck. They're in situations like I just mentioned, and they don't seem to be able to get out at the moment, and they're struggling with it. And so they found comfort in those channels that pray for them, that listen to them, that understand them. I remember many years ago in my very brief first marriage in my 20s, I was going through the breakup process, and I remember seeing one of my best girlfriends come out of the post office, and she saw me, but I looked down, and then I pulled out and I left. I didn't connect with her. Why? Well, I wouldn't do that again because, well, she was a best girlfriend, and I should have just went up to her and told her what was going on. But she was also not the most comforting person, and her life was amazing. And she was, you know, I had this amazing life and now it was falling apart, and her life was amazing. And I didn't want to go around her at that time. Now, I wished her well, she was wonderful. I wanted her to be happy, but yet I was not feeling good about myself. I really wanted to be around other people who maybe were struggling and going through their own difficulty that could shed compassion on me. And I really didn't think she was the one to give me compassion. And although, like I said, I wouldn't have done that now, I would have, you know, and later I got back together with her and all of that. But it was just that I wasn't feeling good about myself, and I really wanted to be around comforting people, not people where everything was going so perfect in their life and mine was not. I was happy for her, and I believe that most people who are stuck are happy for people that are happy. And yet, often it when they're around people like that that are happy and everything's going well, it makes them kind of feel badly. And so I understand that. And, you know, it maybe shouldn't be that way. And maybe those people that are doing really well can be the most comforting people. And yet sometimes when we're going through a difficult and challenging time, we want to find people who are going through something similar that can help us or at least understand. And we feel a camaraderie there. When I had my brain aneurysm, I went to a stroke rehabilitation group, and I met people who were going through similar ordeals, some of them very severe, all kinds of situations. And I felt a sense of warmth and understanding and belonging with that group for that period of time. And did I keep trying to dig my way out of that being stuck? Absolutely. I kept doing all the right things to make myself better. And yet when we're stuck, often we need comfort. Sometimes advice doesn't work when we've had all the advice, when we're doing everything right, and when it's a matter of time, whether it's short time, medium time, or long time. And so comfort is a necessary part of going through the stuck process. Now, like I said, this video is not for those people who are just too lazy to get unstuck or who just haven't found the answer. Because if you haven't found the answer, you need to go out and, I believe, search for your answer until you get unstuck. But this video is for people who are stuck at no fault of their own, and they're stuck because of a situation that is out of their control at the moment. And so for those people, I believe in gathering the right information, gathering the right professional support, gathering the right comfort people. Not all people are comfort people, and some people who look like comfort people really are not comfort people. So you got to find the right comfort people. And if you don't know any, often there's many support groups and many comforting channels on YouTube and other venues on social media. But find comforting people to surround your life while you're going through that period of being stuck in a place that you don't want to be. And keep the faith, knowing that at some point, hopefully, you will get unstuck. And keep surrounding yourself with wise people who make great decisions, professional people that can help pull you out of that being stuck. But while you are going through that journey of being stuck in a place that you don't want to be, make sure you're being comforting to yourself and finding other people who will be comforting to you. From my house to yours, may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all four of my channels: Grandma's Adventures with Diana Brienne Fairchild, Grandma's House with Diana Brienne Fairchild, Grandma's Porch with Diana Brienne Fairchild, and my original channel with 3,400 videos, Diana Brienne Fairchild. So from Grandma's Porch, may God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye. Thank you.
to relax.